Hey guys, good morning. So right now it's 11:18. Look at my hot ass boyfriend. Anyway, so it's 11:18, right? I wish you could see how I'm sitting right now. This setup is not as easy as it looks. So I woke up at around 9:15 this morning. Your girl went to bed at like 11:30. Can you believe it? If you're new to my channel, you may be like, okay, but that's early for me, okay. Also, I'm FaceTime with my boyfriend. Let's see how many times I mentioned my boyfriend in this video. We fell asleep on FaceTime together, so it was much easier for me to go to sleep. But yeah, so I went to bed at a decent time, woke up at a decent time. I feel well rested, so this is good news. Today's video is sponsored by Foreo. Foreo has improved my life and my skincare routine, and I'm so excited to be sharing them with you guys in another video. So stay tuned for that. You know we gotta do the skincare before the workout because that's actually really important. So keep watching to learn more about Foreo. But in today's video, I'm basically bringing you guys kind of like a day in my life, you know, a little vlog. Today's plans. I'm going to go to the gym because that's something I do on a regular. Today I want to do legs. This is going to be my second time doing legs this week. It's Saturday, but it took me forever to recover from the last one. So here we are now, I'm doing legs today. That should be fun, that should be intense, so that's good. And after that, I'm gonna come home, I'm gonna take a shower, I'm gonna get ready, do my hair. I don't know what I'm doing with my hair today, but do my hair. And then Lee and I, and maybe Sammy, I haven't asked him if he wants to go or not, but I'm gonna invite him to come with us to go to downtown. If you don't know, I live in North Carolina. Yeah, so we wanna go to downtown Raleigh and just kind of explore the city a little bit more. It's a pretty big city and there's lots that we have not experienced yet, so I'd like to go downtown and find some new spots to go to down there. So with all that being said, let's go ahead and hop in the bathroom and I'll talk to you guys once we get in there. All right, so first thing we're gonna do is brush my teeth so I don't have to talk to you guys with some hot ass breath. So one thing my boyfriend has taught me, not really taught me, but something I just started doing because of him, because I've realized I'm like part Tito now, is brushing your teeth. Let me turn off the water before people attack me. Is brushing your teeth with hot water and rinsing with cold. Why did we not think of this before? It makes complete sense. You wash everything else. You wash your body. You wash dishes. That's what removes like grease and everything like that with hot water. So why would we not brush our teeth with hot water? And when he first mentioned that, I was like, ew, that's disgusting. But then I tried it on my... Well, I feel like I'm getting a deeper clean. Let me get my mouth washed. Okay. All right, so it's time to talk about Foreo. You guys have probably heard me talk about them on my channel before. Foreo is one of my most used products in general, whether it's sponsored or not, because yes, this video is sponsored by Foreo. They basically make products targeted towards pre-workout skincare and post-workout skincare. So definitely right up my alley. Do you have to be working out to use these products? Absolutely not. But it is literally targeted towards people that get really sweaty, are working out in the gym and need a deep cleanse before and after their workout. So it comes in this super cute pouch, and they actually recently came out with the Luna Mini 3. You guys have heard me talk about their Luna Mini 2, but they did come out with a new version recently. Look at this beautiful color. This is their sunflower yellow color. Let me show you guys what my last one looked like, which is what I've been using for the past few months, ever since I received this product. This is the one I was using before. This is their new one. My last one was this really pretty blue color, but now I have this yellow and I absolutely love it. It's gonna be perfect for the spring and summer. I continue to use Foreo products because I genuinely feel like I'm getting a much deeper clean while cleansing my face with their products. Whenever I just wash my face with my hands, it does not feel anywhere near as clean as I feel with my Luna Mini 3. The Luna Mini 3 has 12 adjustable cleaning intensities, so you can literally personalize how your Luna Mini 3 works for you. Just get a more personal cleanse in general. This device is 100% waterproof, so you can literally put any part of it completely under the water, no damage. And you can also get 400 uses off of one charge. So literally charge this once and you can be using this for months without even thinking about having to charge it again, which I think is so cool. So no batteries needed. It comes with a charger. Just plug it in overnight for one night. You don't even have to plug it in all throughout the night, but that just makes sense. And then you wake up and you have 400 uses. Since this is a gym-friendly device, it does come with this little travel bag. You can literally just toss it in here, throw it in your gym bag, so you can use this to wash your face after your workout before you even leave the gym. Because I know I be feeling nasty after my workouts, like sweaty. I feel good, but I'd prefer prefer to have a fresh face while feeling satisfied after my workout, you know? So literally this is perfect. So whenever you put it in this little pouch, it keeps it clean, and you literally just take it in and out of this pouch, put it back in the pouch when you're done using it, throw it in your gym bag, and you're good to go. So I like to use my Luna Mini 3 before and after my workout. I'm gonna talk to you guys on why I like to use it before my workout now, but then I'll talk to you guys why I like to use it after my workout, because I do use it again after my workouts. So if you were wearing makeup, for example, the day before you're going to the gym, even if you weren't wearing makeup before, it's really nice for your skin to just have a clean slate before you go to the gym, so there's no excess oil and dirt just collected on your face, because going to the gym and sweating is one of the best ways to detox your body. Sweating is your body's natural way of detoxing. Sweating is healthy. Sweating is a good thing. So with the Luna Mini 3, you're able to completely cleanse your face and get rid of all the extra buildup on your skin. So once it's time to go to the gym and you're sweating, you're able to fully detoxify like your body is trying to do without anything blocking your skin and slowing down that process or not allowing it to work like it's supposed to. And I am going to show you guys how I like to use it right now. So the first thing I like to do is wet my face with some warm water, and I also wet my Luna Mini 3. Okay, super quick and easy. So the next thing I like to do is I get my face wash. Whatever face wash you use, no matter what face wash you're using, the Luna Mini 3 is going to make your skincare products you're already using more effective. So I like to turn it on. There's like low pulsation modes, and then you can also make it pulsate like this. And this is how I like to use it, just because I feel like I'm getting a deeper clean. So I'm washing my face with it, and as you guys can see, it's making my face wash suds up. It's literally a massage for your face. It's actually really relaxing and feels really good. So once I'm done washing my face with the device, I like to rub my skin under some warm water again, and I also just rinse this off with warm water to clean it. So that's how I like to use my Luna Mini 3 before my workout. And now I just have a clean, fresh slate. So now it's time to go to the gym. I can actually sweat out my toxins from my body and just go with my skin feeling clean. Like, that's just a good feeling to know your skin has been deeply cleaned before your workout, or not before a workout. All right, guys, so I'm in the car right now. There's a cat hair in here because I was petting my cat before I got in here. I'm in the car now, and my mom's actually gonna come with me. We like to go to the gym together. We won't do like the same workout together, but we just go together and then meet up at the end and dip. So it all works out. It's a good way for us to just both get in and out. So that's what we're gonna do. I'm waiting for her now, but I'm just chilling in the car. Yeah, I'm just gonna wait for her to get in here, and then we'll head that way. I'm addicted to my hands being moisturized. Like, after I wash my hands, I have to put on lotion, like, every time. Washing my hands makes them so ashy, and we just can't do ash. We just can't. Simmy's coming! I'ma break the bank. I'ma break the bank.
He's in the driver's seat, bruh.
The dog do be driving, bruh.
It looks like he's like intentionally ignoring the hell out of you.
He's in his own world. He just sniffed some catnip, so he really on a different planet. All right, guys, so I'm back at the house now. I finished my workout at the gym. So then after that, we went to Lowe's. And then after that, you know, I had to stop and get some coffee. The order I get at Starbucks every single time, literally the last time I was there, not today, but the last time, they were like, is that literally all you get? And I was like, yeah. So this is a venti iced dirty chai with 2 shots as in espresso shots. And yeah, this shit is fire, and I already feel it going through my system, and I already have to take next thing we're doing today. Well, first of all, let me give you guys a little update. Lee had texted me because he has work today, and he was supposed to get off at 3, but now he's not gonna get off till 4, so therefore he won't get here until 6 or 7, he said. But that's fine, I'm in no rush. With that being said, I have hella free time. I'm just going to clean up my room. I have laundry on my bed, and I have some stuff on the floor. We're gonna clean that up because I can't function in a dirty room. So I'm gonna clean my room, turn on some tunes, gonna clean my room, and then after that I need to wash my face because I feel crusty. Then I'm gonna take a shower. Then I'm just gonna chill a little bit because I don't have to get ready as soon as I thought I would. So this is what my room is looking like now. Definitely much better than it looked before. We got a package! My belly button piercing is finally healed. And I ordered another one recently, and I got it in the mail, and it looked like a stripper belly button ring, and I wasn't about it. So these should be a little more low key. Ooh. Oh my God, I love that. They both look super pretty.
Those are all.
We got this one right here. We have this one, which I absolutely love. Looks like that. And then I got a bag of some other ones. These are super cute, and I'm really excited to change my belly button piercing. I just want something that's a neutral color. That was ultimately like my go-to color for the body jewelry, but they didn't have it. So I did blue, which I really like. But whenever piercing's healed, like all you want to do is change it. So that's great. I'm super excited to do that. My belly button ring is screwed on so tight, I can't loosen it without like latex gloves, which I don't have. So once I get those, I will definitely be unscrewing that. I may even do that today. But right now I'm making some food because I was cleaning my room and I can start to feel the hunger coming on. As soon as I feel it, I have to eat because it's just not a pretty sight when I get hungry. So I'm making rice now, and then I'm gonna cook this like crab slash fish stuff. I've shared it with you guys on my channel before, but I'll show you guys again. It's basically like a pre-cooked meat that you can just put in the pan, season it a little bit, and then I mix that with the rice. And then I also make broccoli because I try to eat a vegetable with lunch every day. While this is cooking, we're gonna wash my face because I really want to do that right now. All right guys, so as you guys know, I am back from the gym now, and one of my favorite things to do after a workout is to cleanse my face with my Luna Mini 3, because like I said earlier, after a workout my skin just feels super dirty, oily, sweaty, salty, and that's not something you want to leave on your face after a workout. Having substances like that sit on your face is literally a breeding ground for bacteria and skin conditions that we do not want. So I'm going to be cleansing my face once again with my Luna Mini 3. We got it in the little bag right here. You guys know what we're doing at this point. So I'm just gonna get this wet again and cleanse my face. Super excited. This is from my cat this morning. My skin, it doesn't look bad, it's just like sticky and dirty. So we're gonna change that. But first, we're gonna get my skin wet along with my device. So now I'm just going to put my face wash on my Luna Mini 3, turn it on, and cleanse my face. Removing all the excess dirt, oil, and sweat off your face after workout is actually gonna allow your current skincare products to become more effective on your skin. It's gonna allow them to go deeper into your pores because you don't have any excess substances blocking your skin's ability to do that. Once you use this product once, you'll just know. You can feel a difference. I can talk all day, but once you actually use it, you'll see exactly what I'm talking about after the first use. So after it pulsates 3 times, that means it's done. It literally turns off by itself. It's so smart. So I'm just gonna rinse it off now. And now I'm gonna actually rinse the soap off my face. And then I'm just gonna pat dry my face. Seriously, a game changer. Now my skin is no longer oily. It feels super soft. Sweat, dirt, saltiness, gone. Diminished, okay? So I'm gonna go moisturize my face, and then that's it for my skincare for now. So as I had shared with you guys earlier, I am cooking this crab-like meat. It's actually called imitation crab. It's a mixture of both crab and one other type of fish mixed together. It's super good. I'm seasoning it. I plop that over rice, add in some steamed broccoli, and that's what I like to eat for lunch a lot of the time.
Hey guys, so I'm finished eating and I'm out of the shower now. I'm nice and clean, moisturized, I smell good. I brushed my teeth again. My armpits are burning for some reason. After I put my deodorant on, they're just burning. So hopefully that subsides soon, but I did get this body wash recently. This is the Method Body Cucumber Seaweed Green Tea Deep Detox Body Wash. This shit's a little pricey, but it's amazing, and it's definitely much better for your skin than other products out there, as in like harmful ingredients. Not like my biggest concern, but that is a benefit to it, and that's why it's a little pricier. My armpits, I feel like I can't even put my arms down. It is 5:21. I ate lunch late as shit. Today's just been like a slow day. I don't know. It's like going by so fast that like I can't keep up. Lee should be here in about an hour actually. I like how I literally had the whole entire day, and I always push everything back until I always have like an hour to get ready. I want to do my makeup. Currently in super comfy clothes. This is my boyfriend's shirt that I took from him, and then Nike sweatpants. I'll change later on. I don't know what the
I'm wearing.
For my hair, I was thinking of doing a cute like rubber band hairstyle, but girl, we got an hour and my hair would take half of that time. So I'm actually gonna start with my makeup first, which is something I never do, but I'm gonna start with my makeup first to just have that out of the way, because then like once you got your face beat, like the hair doesn't even matter. Nobody's looking at your hair. So I'm just gonna turn on some music and do my makeup. I'm not gonna walk you guys through it because I feel like I do that in every video, and at this point, if you're a consistent watcher, you already know how my skincare routine goes down. So I'm gonna just do my makeup like I always do. I actually made an appointment. This isn't even open. Your girl made an appointment to get eyelash extensions again, and I know at this point you're probably like, girl, give up. See, I'm kind of telling myself that too, but I booked an appointment with a lady I used to get my lashes done by before I got an allergic reaction. So I booked 3 appointments. I booked a full set appointment, which you have to do so you have lashes to get fill-ins, and then I booked a fill-in 2 weeks later, and then for a week later I booked another fill-in, a 1 week fill-in, because that would be right before I go to Playlist, and I don't want to be like 1 week into my lashes and then I go to Playlist and then they're falling out and I look ghetto as and I can't do anything about it because I'm in Florida. First world problem, definitely, but I want my eyelashes to look fresh if I still have them by that point and don't have to get them removed because of an allergic reaction. So I booked that. My first appointment is November, girl, sweetie. My first appointment is February 8th, and then I have one February 21st, and then I have one February 27th. I'm really hoping they work. It's just so convenient. Like, you guys don't understand. That's why I love them. I didn't even wear makeup when I had lashes. Like, you just feel like a bad bitch morning and night right when you wake up. And then I'll be going on vacation. I'm getting them before I leave for Texas to see my boyfriend. I haven't even talked about that on here. I'm gonna tell you guys about that. I like how I said I was gonna do a time lapse, but now I can't stop talking. Yeah, so I booked an appointment February 8th. I leave for Texas to see my boyfriend February 12th. So that way I get my lashes beforehand, but it gives me a couple days to see how my eyes react to the lashes. So if I do get a reaction, I can get them removed before I go. But I really want them to work just because, bitch, if I got lash extensions, the makeup bag ain't even coming with me. I lie, it will, because if we end up going on like a date or something, I'm gonna wanna feel like extra cute. But girl, the lashes do it for me. Like, that's literally all I want. Once you get lashes, like, you just can't go back. I mean, obviously you can. Yeah, so that's the plan, but I know you guys are probably like, what you mean going to Texas? I feel like I haven't mentioned that in a video yet. I'm flying to see my boyfriend who lives in Texas February 12th. I'm going to Dallas, Texas, and we are staying in an Airbnb together for a week. I am so excited. This is gonna be our first time like alone. Like, when he was here, we had personal time, like we had time by ourselves, but this is our first time like alone. Yeah, that should be fun. I'm super excited, and it'll give us, just poke myself in the eye, it'll give us a taste of living alone. I just did it again. It'll give us a taste of living alone, because, you know, yeah, fun stuff. So that's what I'm doing in like less than 2 weeks. What is it today? 11 days. We've been counting down. I'm literally obsessed with him. So then I'll be in Texas until February 19th. And February 19th, I fly back to North Carolina, which is where I am now. That's where I live. And then I'll be home for what, less than a week? Yeah, so I'll be home for 9 days. And then I fly back out, but this time we go into Orlando for Playlist Live. So if you're going to Playlist Live, I will be there. So that's fun. This is gonna be my second year going. Actually, my second year being invited, which is crazy. Like, how'd you even find me? Why you want me to go? I don't know, but I'm not complaining. So Playlist lasts from February 28th to March 1st, but I won't be leaving Orlando until March 2nd. So then I come back, and then Tito Lee and I actually all plan to visit St. Croix over spring break. If you guys don't know, that's actually where both of them are from. I've never been there. Yeah, that's our plan. I feel like, first of all, it's absolutely beautiful. Like, I am going to be such a tourist, let me just say that right now. But also, I feel like it's important for me to see where he's from, get a taste of what it's like, where he's from, where he grew up, how he was raised, that type of thing, because that's something that interests me a lot and I feel like it's really important. So I am so excited to do that. Like, you guys don't understand, like, Florida who? Super excited for that. We haven't made any official plans, but it's been talked about multiple times, and that is what we plan on doing for spring break. So that's absolutely insane. I have a feeling I'm not gonna want to come back home after that. That'll be like mid-spring, because that's when spring break is. Once I get back, it's time to move out, because my move-in date is March 25th. So once I get back from St. Croix, it's time to move out. out. And by that point, I would have ordered like my furniture and everything like that. I haven't ordered anything yet. I honestly can't get myself to buy anything because I've bought furniture for like my room before, but I'm buying like furniture, like living room furniture, bedroom furniture, guest room furniture, kitchen utensils, kitchen. I was about to say appliances, but thankfully it comes with the appliances. Yeah, like big girl moves, big girl purchases, and no, it's not inexpensive. Haven't done that yet, but I will. Also plan to make a trip to IKEA to take a look there at what they have to offer. The closest IKEA to me is Charlotte, North Carolina, so we will be taking a road trip. I think the closest IKEA to me is like 3 hours from where I live, so that'll definitely be a road trip that I will be taking. So then Tito is still in college, and he will be until May, and you know what happens in May whenever he comes back? He moves in with me, and that's all I'm saying for now. Did I think in a million years at I would be moving in with my boyfriend at 18? Absolutely not. I'm not even gonna get into detail about that yet. That is like a whole another topic, but I do want to say, I did want to at least say that he will be moving in with me once he is done. I am going to have an absolutely insane next couple months. So much is going on, I can't even keep up myself, but it's all amazing stuff. It's all super exciting. It may seem like, especially moving seems not far away, but it seems like I got a good amount of time until I move out. But I know it's literally gonna creep up on me so quick, especially because I won't even be here a majority of the month. 2020 is off to an amazing start. So I'm now applying, or I used my Fenty Beauty matchstick, which is kind of like a cream contour. And now I'm adding some cream blush. And then I'm also gonna go in with my Do Effect highlighter by Glossier and put it here, even though I'm gonna put powder highlight on top of it. I feel like this is a good base to allow it to stick and then also just give me some extra glow. But this is definitely a good product for like a no makeup makeup look. It's so dewy, it's not shiny, it's like dewy. And yeah, Glossier products are like that. Eyebrows are done, face makeup is done, other than setting powder. I'm gonna use just a regular setting powder, not a loose powder, that's the word I was looking for, because I may want to get some pictures tonight and we cannot afford to have no flashback. We're just gonna use regular powder, that's my skin tone, because it doesn't do that. And I honestly don't see any difference between loose powder and just like a regular compact setting powder. Why my eyebrow move? I just put gel on them. So now I'm gonna use this darker powder to kind of contour my face a little bit. So my makeup is now done. Lee is sharing his location with me and it says he'll be here in like 15 minutes. Should I attempt a rubber band hairstyle? I think yes. So I'm literally gonna watch my video, as conceited as that sounds, to figure out how to do the rubber band bun again, because I forgot. First I split my hair down the middle. Also this time around, I don't know if you guys watched that video, but I used colorful rubber bands for every rubber band hairstyle I did in that video. But for today I'm gonna do black, just so I can literally wear anything and not have to worry about color coordinating with all the colorful rubber bands. And I just feel like the black rubber bands are obviously more neutral, but yeah, really I don't think you guys want to hear an explanation about that. I think I kind of remember how to do this. That did absolutely nothing. All right guys, so I'm back with Lee. Lee is back in another video. I know some of you guys have really been wanting to see him in another video, and here he is. So right now it is, I'm literally yelling. Whenever it's time for me to film, I literally yell. Like I project my voice so much. Yeah. Cause then like you go to put background music on it and you can't even hear yourself if you don't project your voice. So it's 6:52 right now and we are about to head to Raleigh to just kind of explore. But before we go and do that, we're gonna go to Walmart like I said I wanted to do, because we gotta get these latex gloves. I'm changing my belly button ring tonight. Yeah, we're gonna go to Walmart first, little evening Walmart trip, and then we're gonna start heading to Raleigh. All right guys, so we are out of Walmart now. Totally forgot to bring my camera in, but I did find the latex gloves. I'm so excited. You guys don't understand, but I got the latex gloves. That's literally all I needed, because you can't grip the ball with your hands. For a snack on the way there, I got some Oreo Thin Bites. These are the white fudge version. They also have a chocolate version, but these hit. This is where it's at.
These are really good. So now we're gonna go downtown. We're actually going to a place that I've never been before, he's never been before, so this will be super interesting. I don't know how parking's gonna go. I don't even know like what's really there, so that'll all just be new experiences that we'll figure out once we get there. All right guys, so about 30 minutes later, we're here now. Yeah, I guess we're just gonna start walking, check it out. It's kind of like an outdoor shopping center slash, I honestly don't know what this is, but it's somewhere we've never been, and that's what this video is kind of about. Yeah. And there's a lot of cars here, so something must be popping. All right guys, so there's like nobody here. Like it's super chill, and I can definitely see this being a cool place to go, especially whenever it's actually warm, but it's super pretty. I've literally never been here. I didn't even know this was a thing until I was just itching my hand, until my older brother had recommended it to us. We kind of don't know where we're going. We're just kind of trying to figure out the area and what's around, but we did see a sushi place. Might just have to go there. But look how cute this area is. Guys, we're at this restaurant and we don't really want to eat here, so we're just dipping. We haven't ordered or anything yet, but bitch, why am I so nervous? I'm not built for this. I'm not made for this type of behavior. I can't do it. Dipping. Okay, I'm nervous. Whenever I'm nervous, I do things like way too fast. He's really just gonna go back to the table. We're gonna be gone. That is so bad. Okay, so we went past here. Did we not? Oh no, we didn't. We went through here. All right, so we're walking back to our car now. We parked in this parking lot, right? And in downtown, you're pretty much paying to park anywhere, and I completely just forgot to pay. So I'm really hoping I don't have a ticket. Oh, we finessed the system?
How do you always finesse?
Oh yeah, the one time he tried it, he got a ticket. So I'm home. I've been home for maybe 45-ish minutes, was on the toilet for a majority, and now I'm back in my room. I'm gonna be honest, I am so tired. As I expressed earlier, I did film this video yesterday as well. And other than that, your girl hasn't, what the f is on my shirt? I've been super laid back, laying low. Whenever I'm by myself, I just have like my own routine, and it doesn't include much like going out. I'll go out, but it's not to actually go out and do activities, like actually hanging out with friends. It'll be like editing. So yeah, your girl's really tired. Now that I'm home, I'm going to take my makeup off and wash my face once again. I'm gonna hop in the shower, get nice and clean, but not wasting any time in there because I am so tired, okay? So first things first, we rip off the lashes and then we take off the makeup. Getting unready is making me so excited because I'm so tired. Like, I've not done a full face of makeup like that in a minute. So to take care of my skin before I go to bed, I once again use my Luna Mini 3. This is the third time I'm using this device today. And that's typically how often I like to use it on a daily basis. I like to use it before my workouts in the morning, after my workouts, and then also before I go to sleep, because that's when I'm removing the majority of any leftover makeup, dirt, oil off my face that has collected all throughout the day. I will have the link in my description box for you guys to check out this product. I highly recommend it, and it is most definitely an upgrade to your skincare routine.
Because I don't fit in the club.
I didn't think about that, but we're gonna try it. All right, so I'm out of the shower now. I washed my face. I'm nice and clean, and I feel a lot better. What?
You're so cute.
So now we're about to change this belly button piercing because I've been too excited to do this. Like, can I please change it now? He said my claws aren't gonna fit in here, and I didn't think about that.
Oh wait, you posting this video somewhere?
YouTube?
No, I know, but like, in which video?
This video.
Oh, okay.
What?
Are they just filming it to film it?
Oh no, this is still a part of my video. So I'm not gonna show this because that'd literally be so hard, but I'm basically trying to unscrew the ball on the top. Latex gloves are supposed to give me a good enough grip to actually unscrew the ball on the top. I'm not gonna promise I'm gonna be able to do it right now. It's twisting around in my stomach, but it's not actually unscrewing.
The,
like the bar, the actual piercing is twisting around, but not the actual ball.
Man, if I was there, I would have unscrewed that thing one time.
Maybe I need to put two gloves on.
Dr. Williams.
Yeah. Oh, I'm getting powder on my pants from these gloves because they're lightly powdered. Okay. Yeah, this won't move. It literally won't move. So I'm probably gonna have to actually, my phone just died. I'm probably gonna have to actually go to the tattoo parlor for them to switch it out for me, because your girl literally can't get a grip on it. That's crazy. Like, that's so tight, because these latex gloves give me such a good grip on it, but I still can't untwist it. But I'm plugging in my phone so I can FaceTime my baby back. But yeah, guys, that is it for today's video. I'm gonna close this video off here. It's like 11:30. I am so tired. Very happy to be home, comfortable. I was about to say in bed. We're not there yet, but we will be after I end this video. But I really hope you guys enjoyed it. I haven't done like a vlog. I mean, a majority of my videos are somewhat vlogs, but I really enjoyed this one, and I hope you guys did too. If you guys have got all the way to the end and you have not subscribed yet, please make sure to do so. Also, if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. Thank you guys so much for watching. I love you all so much, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.